It's all a mess. There's my drink. Where's the Discord?
Hello.
Sup?
Not much. Good to see you. Oh my god, an app default was reset. I just got 6 notifications for each one of them that got reset. Thank you.
What just reset?
My media player updated, and like it had to like uninstall the old one, I guess, to put the new one on, and it was like, well, it doesn't exist anymore, so we're gonna make Groove Music your new default for everything. It's like, gross. Oh, thanks. That's a pretty funny gif.
Oh, that guy just throws the people.
Yeah.
Oh boy, Sumbro, it's Friday.
It sure is.
I'm happy. It's just medicine. Where's your butt? Where's your butt online? This is kind of like a galaxy. Oh, he's playing Stellaris, that's what.
Alrighty.
Sick. I saw that anime girl at the place again, Sumbro.
Oh yeah?
At the Mad Greens.
You guys dating now? You got it. You sold her on it, didn't you?
I wish.
Her. You fucking Casanova, as we learned what that means.
Ugly Casanova.
Ugly, not ugly. Don't say that.
That's a good band, though.
Oh. Well, you're definitely not in that band, so.
You might want to get out of your watermelon.
Okay. I'm changing. Yeah, I'm getting my dad. Had to have some emergency dental work done, so.
Ooh.
Yeah, he's not feeling good. He's laid up in bed right now. Just making sure everything's alright. He was like puking and stuff.
I think Ooh.
Tooth was getting abscessed.
This girl though, the line was really long, so I didn't have too long to talk to her. I was like, hey, I started watching Hunter x Hunter. She's like, oh, you did? Did you like it? Or do you like it? I was like, I'm on episode 40, if that tells you.
Oh my god, you like just started that recently.
Yeah.
You're making some progress, Jesus.
And,
those are like 20 minute episodes?
Yeah.
Or like, 24 or whatever.
Yeah. So. Jeez.
You must be on some level enjoying it, unless you're just doing it for research.
research. No, I like it. I like it. It's fun.
God, this anime sucks. Oh yeah, it's great. It's like, oh man, it could be one of my favorites, I think.
Probably, yeah. Ooh boy.
I love when the main character does all the stuff that he does.
The really annoying, great he, stuff that he does.
He or she does. Like, hedge your bets. and the crisis that occurs that the main character will have to solve. And various other problems that they'll have to overcome. So, set the scene. You went... It's like a salad place or something. Didn't you say something greens?
Yeah, it's a salad place.
And so you walk in, you're like... Yo.
Oh, shit!
I need a salad.
I saw her. I was like, oh, shit!
Shit! I didn't know you were going to be here. God damn it.
They got me. Oh, ooh, no. So yeah, she had like a, she put like a sideways smirk when she,
ooh.
And she's like kind of like, ah, you got it. I should wonder earlier. So she's kind of like cool. She's like, she sees me, she's like, hey.
I will not take kickoff. I'm setting up your Twitch chat right now.
I don't know. See, I don't even know anything of if she likes me or not, but it seems like she...
If she gave you a sideways smirk and a hey, you are in.
Yeah, and it was just
she
like
is,
a hey.
She is begging for it.
You're
doing her a disservice by not asking her out.
Oh, don't score it, though. Oh,
I was
God.
Trying. I just didn't have any boost.
Yeah, that's all. I mean, we just exchanged the we're talking about the characters and whatnot, and she loves Kurapika, and I was like thinking, yeah, she would.
God damn.
I didn't tell her that, but yeah, it seems like a person that would.
Okay, so now you have to tell me what this character is like, so that I can judge her based off of the character she likes.
He's like calm and collected sometimes, but then like, but he's, you know, he's got his like dark side and his side where he rages and it's just like a Sasuke, but not as cool.
I was gonna say Sasuke.
So.
I did really like Sasuke when I was younger.
Oh fuck!
I thought that the emo shtick was badass.
I think Sasuke's still cool. I think Kurapika's great. But
I still like the character, but I don't buy into the emo thing of being like, alright. Like, I'm not like, whoa, I want to be like that. I want to be too cool to care about things.
Yeah. And he's like short and blonde. I think she's short
and
blonde.
There's
so
a difference
know.
Between enjoying a character and wanting to be a character. I think is the point. There's a bunch of characters that I'm a big fan of, but I wouldn't want to like emulate or actually think of them.
But, yeah, I don't know. Ooh. My favorite character so far is Hisoka. Hisoka, he's a very good villain if he's a villain. I don't know if he's a villain. He's like a rogue.
Oh my god, what a pass. I feel like a lot of times anime makes it way too easy to see who the villain is. It's a little too obvious and cliche and one-dimensional.
Yeah.
This isn't like the creepy smile or the creepy glasses kind of thing.
This guy's real creepy, but he's helped out the main characters a lot.
That's cool.
And so, but he's also like gone against them a couple times, and so he's just very rogue.
Shoved stick in me.
Whenever he hears about like he's gonna fight a powerful opponent, he basically has an orgasm. Like his eyes will roll back, his head.
Like that dude from Bleach with the long hair, the guy that was just like bored of fighting and wanted to.
I don't know who that is.
Good opponent. I don't remember his name either. That was the first time I saw that. In anime, where it was like,
I'm so powerful, I'm bored, and I need a challenge.
He doesn't say, like, he's bored necessarily, but, like, every single time he's, like, ooh, thinking of fighting him, and then he'll roll, he'll tilt his head back and roll his eyes back, and he'll be like, like, he literally makes the orgasm. And I think he said about getting erect just thinking about it. I think he said that.
So, okay, that's hilarious.
Like, he's so... He's such an interesting character. He's part of the villain organization, but the villain organization, like, he's still like a rogue within him? Because, again, he helped out the main characters while working for the villain organization, and, like, I don't... Oh, boy. So I'm hoping, you know, obviously I'll find out more, but he's really cool.
Speaking of anime, real quick, I finished... the Netflix show that I've been binge watching. It was a really fantastic show. So I've got an open slot, and there's stuff I do want to watch, but I feel like it's probably about time for me to finally start on My Hero Academia. Where's the best place to go for that?
Oh, I don't know. Wherever. Wherever you want. Crunchyroll. There's also Kiss Anime.
That's the nefarious one.
Yeah. Crunchyroll has them all out, though.
But I have to watch with commercials?
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of commercials. Probably like nine per episode-ish.
And Kiss Anime, is it just streaming? You just go to the page, yeah. You click on it, and start watching it?
Yeah, you have to like do a captcha and stuff. The captcha is very interesting too. Their site, like, click on the picture that has these in it, and it'll be like the number 9 bear in yellow. You're like, all right, well, there's that.
Shit. Well, that's still faster than watching a commercial, so.
Yeah, it was, you know, it's got a pop up ad, but. But yeah, the Hisoka character, he's got a weird visual design. He's kind of got like a playing card kind of jokery villain like character design.
That's cool. I like that. I remember the Joker in Batman the Animated Series where he like threw playing cards like they were daggers, and I thought that was the coolest shit ever.
I don't think he's Joker from Batman.
Yeah.
I was a Joker on a card.
I was just saying that I like that kind of style.
Yeah.
Because of that show.
Yeah, he definitely throws playing cards and like makes them stick in the shit. He does other things.
I mean, it's cheesy as hell, but I love it.
Oh, the fucking universe has, you know, it's like aura and concept and whatnot. Like, it's your chi, your energy. And the pacing of the show is really fast, too. That's a nice thing. Not like, I'm going to do seven weeks of training or whatever. And we're going to represent that in 10 episodes. It's like, yeah, we did training for one episode and we got it. I got him! Look at this shit.
PC Load Letter is a pretty funny name. Damn, he had the save, too. That follow-up was vital.
So, that was about the exchange. I told her, she's like, Hisoka's great. He's a little pervy, though. And I'm like, oh, I love Hisoka. And she's like, right? Like, other people don't. Or something like that. I was like, yeah, I love that guy. And so, like,
she's okay with the guy that's kind of pervy, is what you're saying.
Yeah, which is great.
That's awesome. I hate that everyone feels like they have to act like prudes to be acceptable in society.
He's only pervy though because, again, he has an orgasm when he thinks of him fighting. There's like no other pervy side to him. He doesn't.
Oh, that's
there's
really
no.
Pervy.
Yeah.
He's not. He's there's not no looting. Like. He's just has an unconventional reaction to his passion.
Yeah. When you think of like pervy in anime, you think of
I think of Mustang in Full Metal Alchemist saying that when he becomes Fuhrer, he's gonna make all the ladies wear short skirts.
Yeah, yeah, that sort of thing. Or I'm gonna look at your Japantis. Or. Yeah. Ow!
Or the skeevy character that like wants to grab the boobs and then the female character just like pops him on the head or something.
I messed that one up real bad.
I prevented the teammate from hitting that forward, so I put you in the bad position there.
I was trying to catch it and I didn't catch it. But yeah, like, then she's like, yo, yeah, then she said, I look forward to you coming in again. And I was like,
oh my god.
She wants me. You can tell she wants me to buy a salad and have her, she'll make it. She wants to make a, she's already wanting to make food for me and we're not even.
Oh my god. It's the perfect marriage, just like that team play there.
That was the good team play.
Fucking roasted him. Boop, boop, boop.
That was great.
I had to slam on the brakes to get behind it on that last one, but you had already smoked him so bad that it didn't matter.
I was trying to hit it up, actually, and just keep it going forward, but, you know, stopping it was still fine.
Fuck his teammate.
Oh, damn it.
No! She said, I look forward to you coming in again?
Yeah.
My god.
Isn't that like, oh my god, I've never had someone genuinely say that before, and she didn't
feel like fucking royalty at that point.
Yeah.
You are a Greek god.
Oh!
You have godlike status.
Get wrecked! Oh my god. We're doing well in this match, I think.
This one, yeah. Teammate. Look at these plays.
I just sat there, I was like,
We're murdering people.
God, but what a match. This is the best match we're gonna have of the day.
Maybe. it's possible.
I wanted to pinch that. Salty! Mr. Aaron Gorn, how you doing, man?
God, we gotta come up with a greeting. We gotta come up with our unique greeting. Like, good unchi or something with kimochi.
Top of the morning to you!
No. All good? No, that one's not good. Ooh, I think I have that. That was excellent.
Oh, that was...
Top of the morning to you? You want to go with that?
You want it? I say, how are you doing? Is that good enough? Did I say that, though? I don't remember already. It's so natural. How you doing? How's life? I hope everything's good. Let's do that one.
Well, welcome.
Whale come.
I don't know if I'm comfortable with that one every time someone shows up in chat.
You sure? That top of the morning to you really, really grinds my throat, you know? I don't know if I can do that one.
Henlo is real fun to say, but that's kind of... I don't want to just steal what Angel's doing.
Yeah, that's Angel's thing. I'm good at this. We could say, Konbanwa.
No.
That means good evening. We could say Irashaimaze. It means like welcome to our store.
I don't think I'm gonna be able to do the Japanese.
Yokozo.
It's also something Kimochi I want to be able to just like type in chat as well. But if I'm just like watching your stream, I want to come in and be like, boom. Greeting that we all use to foster a sense of community. We can think about it. It doesn't have to be right now.
Yeah, one day. Something will fit, you know? And when it fits, you can feel it. When it doesn't fit, you can also feel it. But besides the point. Oh, I knew he was going to do that, but... Oh. They're after me, Lucky Charms! You could say that, too.
We could say that. It doesn't necessarily translate to a greeting.
I came up with that one myself, though.
Well, I never doubted that. I've never heard that collection of words before. I knew you had to have come up with it.
Oh my god!
I could say, good morning once again, audience. Or welcome once again, audience. Or welcome for the first time, audience. Oh, fuck. Yes, Lucky Charms, that one. You want that one? Oh my god. I don't know.
Hello, he's after me, Lucky Charms.
I can't do a shitty Irish accent without destroying my throat, because I have to yell when doing an Irish accent. Oh, I thought I was gonna bounce out or in or one of the directions. Plus, I feel bad for the Irish that I'm butchering their language. Oh, rain stuff. Oh. They sure are. Speaking of greetings, segue. I got into my work today. Right as I get into the door, my boss is right there. Like, oh. He's like, so, we need everyone from our group to, I thought I was gonna bounce down. Yeah, everyone from our group to basically brag about what we do, but in a very vague way.
What?
So, like, we can't mention specific company names and stuff like that.
Who are you bragging to?
Basically potential other customers in our company, for our company. It has nothing to do with me, necessarily. It has to do with the company's growth. The company I work directly for. He's like, so, because you... you are one of the people that, like, does something that is crazy and unique and all that. You need to... I need you in this meeting. And, said what a save to himself.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, fucking shit. So I have to go to a meeting with him, and then the meeting's during my lunch. I'm like, oh, please. And the meeting was very boring. And my boss, who still doesn't know what I do, and... yeah. that was about it. Like... What they didn't know is I'm like, well, out of all the other competitors and stuff, I'm only like one of... probably 10 people in the world that does what I do out of everybody. So Besides Intel. The people at Intel do. There's probably more people at Intel that do it than the company that makes the test software than there are people in the world that actually utilize it.
Thank you for contribution there, Ashton. We really appreciate you stopping by. Why don't you stick around for the rest of the meeting that you don't really need for?
Yeah, I had to stick around for like 30 minutes for this meeting. I was like right at the beginning too. And there were all the rest of the people that were there were all like the leaders of all the groups and stuff. And then there was me, and I'm like, I'm kind of my own group, aren't I? Like, there's all these leader dudes and I'm there. But I did learn a word, so maybe it was worth it. And the word is anechoic.
Hmm. Continue.
And it means like, I think doesn't produce or doesn't have an echo.
Doesn't have an echo. Interesting.
Yeah. Anechoic.
Why?
Because we have a 10 meter anechoic chamber at work.
Oh, that's cool. I've seen those, I just didn't know that's what they were called.
It's 10 meters cubed. 10 meters by 10 meters by 10 meters. Pretty neat. I've never been inside of it, but.
What are they testing there?
Acoustics.
Well, I figured that I meant like.
Acoustic noise of the computers.
Of the, right. The computer parts.
Of just the computer in general. We want to make sure the computer doesn't make a lot of noise. Mm-hmm. It's one of the buying things. It's like, how much noise does it make? Oh, it's this quiet.
Yeah.
Just to have at your desk. How cool is that? I haven't been to the anechoic chamber, but I've been to the extremely long and blank hallway. Where it's like, it's a very long hallway. So long, and there's like nothing on the walls or anything. And so you walk at the entrance of the hallway, you look down it, and you're just like, holy shit. The end doesn't look like, it doesn't look 3D, because it's so far away. It kind of looks like a painting. Like really far back or something, and I'm like, what the fuck, that doesn't look real. And then you start walking down, it almost feels like you don't make progress for a little while. It's kind of surreal, because whenever you get like long hallways, there's at least stuff on like,
yeah,
the walls and stuff, windows, paintings, like a fire escape thing, or not fire escape, a fire alarm thing.
Yeah, it feels, that sounds like very sci-fi.
Yeah. Very, very interesting. Yeah, first time you see it, you're just like, whoa, weird. I'd love to go into the anechoic chamber, because I hear that if you stay in one of those long enough,
you can hear your own
black.
You can hear like your own blood pumping.
Yeah, you can like potentially start going crazy. That'd be fun. Have them turn off the lights.
Probably take a little while.
That's not. I'm already there. Oh my god.
Well, you know, I did hit it at that angle to get it at the goal. I didn't think it would actually make it all the way there.
I was way off.
Could you imagine hearing? Oh, there's germs! Imagine hearing your own
germs.
Blood pumping.
Oh, yeah, that would be
really weird.
I can, like, hear my heartbeat and stuff sometimes.
And I hate that.
Yeah, I kind of hate it too. Makes me think I'm dying or
yeah.
something. Like, why can I hear my heartbeat right now? Do you ever have, like, the feeling where you can feel part of your body pulsing to your pulse?
Yeah.
That's annoying too.
Yeah, I don't like it.
And it makes me feel like why does it feel so
wrong. Yeah. The worst is if you're trying to go to sleep.
Ooh.
Oh my god! You ever lay there in just like the dead silence of the night and like start feeling, you're just like, oh my god, my body is an active thing that is beating and trying to stay alive right now. Now I can't focus on anything else. That happens a lot if I'm at someone else's house, if I'm not in the comfort of my own room and using like my fan. I use a fan to make a little bit of white noise.
Yeah.
I can't stand when it's... The only thing worse than dead silence at someone else's house is one of those shitty analog clocks that clicks.
Yeah.
Can't stand that.
Dude, I have one in my room, and I don't notice it probably 99.9% of the time, but the other day I was like, why can I hear a clock? And I remembered I have an analog clock.
It's because of your own clock? Holy shit. That's pretty fun.
I never notice it, but it's because most of the time, again, I have white noise going.
Yeah.
And, like, I think that was when I took out my AC unit for the first time. Mm. You know.
Yeah, suddenly you noticed it again.
There's a lot of noises in the house in general that I notice now that all that shit's gone. I still have a fan in my window, but...
I had to take the batteries out of her clock because I literally couldn't get sleep listening to it.
If it's a constant noise, I can go to sleep to it pretty well. Oh, get wrecked. Yurms is gone. I told you he's the guy that leaves.
He is, you're right. You did say that. I didn't have to go to work today because it was raining so much.
That's good. Good.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just... Oh, damn. Got wrecked. Just finished a pretty big job earlier in the week, so it's not a big deal to shuffle some things around for today. Which ended up being good because my dad had to go to the dentist.
Yeah.
It all kind of worked out. Maybe not for him so much, obviously. I was worried about Kristen's dog. I sent her a message and she said that she got off work early today. So she didn't say the dog died or that they had put the dog to sleep. So I don't know if there's any progress in that area.
Yeah.
I'm feeling for her. That's pretty fucking rough.
It's amazing how much, like, because she gets really annoyed at the dog. Like, just really annoyed. And that's all
that
I hear is just...
Basil,
yeah.
She gets annoyed.
And that's, yeah. I think that's partly because he's old and stuff like that. He does annoying things because he's old. It's really amazing that, like, people, despite getting annoyed and all that stuff... from an animal all the time.
Wow. You
know, still get sad and stuff when the dog's gonna pass. Because that's all I would hear out of her.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not gonna deny it's
sad. Yeah, and also maybe she just was talking about the things that annoyed her and not talking about the things that she didn't like about it, so maybe.
Get pissed at him so much, but
yeah.
There's also lots of times that, like, in her life in previous years, that she probably would like the dog. I'm not saying like it's dumb of her to do that or anything hypocritical. It's just like interesting.
Ooh, that was a good hit.
I'm happy I have next Friday off. I thought it was going to be this Friday, but it's next Friday where they turn off the power at my work. So, like, just hundreds and hundreds of machines we have to turn off. Like,
no, I ruined it. Thought we were going to have another tag team passing combo. I just wanted you instead.
That hard drive encryption thing was like, I had to send IT proof that on my computer it says it was encrypted. And so I sent him proof, and I said, "My OS is in Japanese." And so I circled it, and then I put what it, like, the text of what it says, because I took a screenshot, right? And I put the text of what it says, and then I gave him a Google Translate link to the text already translated, and said, "I really hope this stops bothering me now." And I really do, because fuck that person. Fuck that shit, man.
Ooh, my final golden pumpkin.
Reminds me I can buy that thing. I have one more regular thing to buy. And then I'll buy golden pumpkin.
Ugh, breakout. Come on.
God, I don't know. Work. Work is poo-poo. It always is. I got a little box elder beetle hanging out on my TV. Oh, what are you doing there, buddy?
Orange team, so we need to attack in that direction.
Match just started, too. Box elder beetle, what are you doing on my TV? I had one of those on my neck at work the other day. I just felt like a little tingly thing on my neck. Like, God, is my hair getting that long? That, like, I'm feeling it brush up against my,
pass back. Damn, he was ready for it.
I could feel it brush up against, like, my... And then I felt a little tingle again. I was like, what the fuck? Yo, yeah, username. Oh. And then all of a sudden... I was like, wait, what if that's a bug? So I hit my neck and, like, you throw my hands forward because it could be a death spider or something. And I see there's a little box elder beetle with now a leg missing, squirming on my desk. I was like, oh, I'm sorry, buddy. If I would have known, I would have.
I treated you as a hostile.
Yeah.
It was a preemptive strike.
Could have been anything. Could have been a. The world's deadliest spider that they've never discovered. They don't even have anti-venom for.
Could have.
Oh my god, it can't be that guy. It could have been a hardware bug in a computer come to life.
That's where you would find it, is a place that has a bunch of bugs.
Yeah. Alright, Mr. Guy. He's like, no, I don't want your phone. Well, you're missing a leg, dude. You're not the one I destroyed at my work, and you come for revenge, are you?
It's crawled all the way to your house.
I threw you in the trash can with my Qdoba. Problem is, I want to get him off my screen, but I don't want to actually, like, squish him or anything like that. Because he's on my screen.
Yeah, you'd have bug guts. Not good.
Oh, he's getting to the edge. Of glory! Oh. Perfect time to grab the dude. Come here, dude. Come on. Oh, stop. Don't run in the middle again. Stop, please. Stop.
Oh man, that was real whiff from teammate.
Stop, please.
That was
Yeah, there, get on my finger. Okay, crawl on my leg, that's fine too. Well, you're not my face. He's hanging out on my leg. There you go, man. Chillax a little bit. Crawl through the
stream.
Crawl through the myriad of hair.
Myriad of hair.
Is that a good way to describe
that
it?
That is.
I think that was teammate fucking up again. Real bad. He's off my leg now. He got fired.
Myriad of hairs might work. Still a bit of a plethora of hairs.
Cacophony.
Cacophony. Wow.
What are you doing, dude? You're not gonna last very long in nature with that missing leg, probably. Oh, you're gone. All right. See ya. I don't know where you went. Better not be on my neck again.
No.
Hate it when you know there's a bug around and you get all of a sudden you're aware of all the crawlies on your body. All the, like, hair movement.
Now you're imagining bugs that aren't actually there.
Insane.
Damn it.
What a 60 seconds left on the clock. Do anything with that, dude.
Time! There, you have the time. We need something unconventional here, because none of our attacks are getting through the defense. I don't have this.
Ooh, I guess. I wanted to pinch that, and it didn't work.
No, that was it! That was my moment. I had a chance.
Mr. Bug, where'd you go? Well, he's lost in a sea of stuff. His teammate did save one and did get a goal, but he also let two in, so I...
Probably do a PRB after this one.
There's a girl at my work that took a picture of a box elder beetle and was like, "Ew, what is this? Oh my god!" And like, it's a pretty harmless bug. It kind of hangs out. She posted a picture of that next to a picture of a spider eating another bug. It's not. All right, I mean. One of the things you see is kind of gruesome. Other things just a little. And also they're all over the place, so here, I don't know why. Didn't know what they were. They're very...
Oh,
common.
No!
Ha! Very common bug here. I didn't, but I don't like where this is headed.
In.
I did what I could. I got a save.
I'm still real salty about mine not going in. God damn it! No!
Teammate really pre-jumped that. I don't know what he was pre-jumping, but he... Oh, that was a bit too fast. Oh, that was right at him. I was trying to aim somewhere else. Oh, you dick. Oh, you bick. You bick boy.
He's trying to run interference for your clearance.
Oh, he missed
what
it!
What a disappearance by the goalie. See, I can't even read what his avatar says there. It's all covered up. I fucking dare you.
Who, Newsom?
Yeah.
Mine's a question mark. I can't even read it at all.
A bald eagle with an American flag behind it. Looks like it's saying something fucking dare you. probably I fucking dare you or how fucking dare you. Like, how dare you? Oh my god.
Nice one there, too.
Yeah, I fucking dare you.
I think you're just saying things. It's just a big question mark.
Alright, well, honestly, how fucking dare you?
I didn't hear what you just said there. I just heard you be puzzled.
How fucking dare you question me?
You're puzzled and then you said question. Oh. But I don't get it. Oh no. Oh no. Oh boy. Oh god, it was so fast.
Okay, so this will not be a problem. I wanted to take it from him, but I wasn't sure. Oh, that's bad.
Yeah, it is bad. I went way too high. I don't know. I was really wanting to shoot that way out, and then my brain just died.
Been playing Slay the Spire, that card-based roguelike.
Right.
And, I've been doing pretty well. A lot of it's card mechanics, which I ingrained years of Magic the Gathering. So I have some foothold there. Ooh, what a save! On my sixth attempt, I actually beat it. I beat the run. It was my first time using that character as well. So I'm pretty proud of that.
Sounds pretty good. Or the game's just too easy.
Too easy. It did kick my ass the next two times I tried it.
It's also the nature of roguelikes, really.
Well, after 24 hours of Enter the Gungeon, I never beat that one. So,
yeah.
The fact that I did this and in only six attempts, I feel pretty good about that. Oh, I had that. Damn.
Oh, man, they're really blocking that net.
Yeah, they're holding on tight.
Ah, damn it.
It's another couple of shots they just blocked. Just playing keep away right now.
Oh boy, they don't have that.
Oh, teammate, no.
Oh boy.
You got us. You fucking got us. This Patrick guy gets all the goals. This spooky banner.
Oh, I was really trying to get that.
Risky!
Oh, I sucked! It's really bad. I'm really sorry.
That's gonna do it.
Look at, I was so close. Oh, it wiggled! Ooh, psionics.
Damn, you know, I might have saved that if teammate hadn't knocked it out of my way.
Psionics, I want my hit back. Score it right now. Yeah, we're back in the running, kind of.
These assholes don't know how to do a fucking kickoff. That was a sharp angle.
No!
Damn it!
Ugh. Can I have that? I can't get to it. Okay.
You're saying there's a chance!
Ran out of boost! Oh, no.
That's a good clear right there at the end. Because I was ready.
I was ready too, but he... Yeah. I ran out of boost, I would have had it, I think.
He needed a solid clear at the end there, or they were fucked, but he got it.
Just a big solid.
So yeah, I think this is probably going to be the first roguelike that really sinks its hooks into me. Because most of them I played for a while and then put it down. But I'm a sucker for card-based mechanics, and you know, it's just well made. It's fun.
You see that they have a Magic the Gathering, new Magic the Gathering game?
Yeah, but I'm not gonna play Magic the Gathering as a video game. I had a plan for that teammate, but fine. They made a standalone Gwent game as well, with like a storyline.
Yeah.
That card game from...
Storyline, though? I didn't see
that.
Yeah.
Oh! The cut!
Get wrecked.
How long did you spend sharpening the knife to make a cut like that? So the knife... Go ahead.
Huh? I was gonna say it's a good night of Rocket League.
I'm having a fun time with my bro.
I'm doing good. Some bro's here. Just stole it from you.
We don't have anyone in chat, sadly, but otherwise it's going pretty well.
There's some lurkers. People, they're doing their lurks.
So Elite Dangi Boost. The next update, the next live stream is, I read him. Damn.
Mining?
I thought it was, but I think there's actually going to be another one right before the mining. There is going to be one for ships.
Oh!
There is one that is labeled new ships, so that's cool. I think they might actually talk about squadrons next. I can't remember what it is now.
That might
I remember,
be
I expected
probably
it to
squadrons.
Be mining. I expected it to be mining, but I think I saw something else on the 30th. I gotta look it up again.
It's probably squadrons, though, because that's pretty detailed and big.
That is a big part of what they're doing in this one.
Mining.
That could be its own stream.
New ships might be included with mining, maybe, because new ships, there's not necessarily much to talk about, but...
Ooh, you muscled them! Just getting everybody today.
And you just see new ships.
All I can really talk about is hard points and internals.
Yeah. And how many new ships, too? That's the big question.
Yeah, ships plural, that could be cool.
There's two, at least.
And hopefully not just...
Oh, nice one.
Yeah, that demo was key. Hopefully not just like reskins of other stuff that we've got.
Yeah, like, oh, check out this...
New variants.
Yeah. Check out this Asp Explorer that we just lengthened.
Oh, fuck.
I want 30 variants of the Asp. And the Chieftain. I can't believe they have three variants of the Chieftain. I mean, I guess it's not too surprising considering that the Federation has, like, the FAS, the FGS, and the Dropship.
Mm-hmm.
All three of those are kind of like variants of each other. So with different wings.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to hate on variants because it's like, you know, they might as well get extra use out of those models, or at least very similar.
Yeah, I'm not too mad. Obviously, I'd rather have a new ship, but.
Right, yeah. But I do think it's smart use of their time to make variants like that.
Oh yeah.
Especially for mid-range stuff when you're really trying to figure out what you want to do. It's cool to have options.
I feel that the Empire has a lot less repeats in their stuff. Because, you know,
That's probably right.
I think it's mainly because they're similar, like in con, and like they got the long dick body, and then they have the two wings sticking out the side. But, for the most part, they look pretty different from each other. It's mainly because of size too, right? A pretty big size difference between them all.
Yeah.
The Clipper and the Cutter are both large, but the Cutter's definitely bigger. The Clipper is like a.
And it's a company that values style. Damn. I don't know how you found a way to do that.
I don't know either.
They really emphasize style, so you wouldn't expect them, that company in particular, to like rehash an old. Yeah, it's kind of like.
Yeah.
Kind of like Apple, basically. Apple never reuses a form factor, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, they're the sleek guys, though. PRB.
Yes, PRB.
Beep. Oh boy.
Impending greeting.
They're after me, Lucky Charms.
Hi low.
I used to say hi low in text message. Back when I was a hip teenager, you know. Fuck.
I dropped my spinner. Where did it go?
Apparently, it has morphed with the carpet. And it no longer exists on this plane of existence.
This song's so fun. Hold on, I have new pink stuff, so I gotta check it out. Well, I do have synthwave pink.
I like that synthwave boost they added. That one's neat.
That's the one. I have a pink one of it.
It's really cool.
I'll put on my pink car. Kind of doesn't go with my you know, my bunny, this pink bunny aesthetic, but it's good enough. I had another pink thing that... Didn't I just get like a pink set of wheels too or something? What are these? I don't remember having these. Alright. I thought I got a pink set of wheels. Maybe not. I mean, I have one, it's just I thought I got a new one. Mothership, when did I get these? I heard about Mothership. There was like a bug with Mothership, and everyone who had Mothership actually had Mothership Pro. They gave Mothership Pro to other people who should have it.
What is Mothership?
The type of wheel.
Oh.
Candy cane. Oh, that would go really well. Oh, but it's so cute. Isn't that? Or a rainbow? That rainbow is better. And I gotta get. I just got motor mouth. I gotta put motor mouth on there.
Okay, Dark Smoke Puncher.
You still doing that Endless Frontier?
Oh yeah. I might have actually. Ooh.
I gotta say, I'm a little surprised by how much Justin and his ilk are into the ranked rumble.
Yeah. Guess I can't do anything with that. Neither can they! Losers! Oh yeah.
They also crushed the shit out of us.
Yeah, they did.
Right out of us.
Oh, he fucked me.
That's gay.
That's fine.
No!
Oh boy. I don't have a good defense for this guy.
Glad teammate waited until the ball dislodged to use his glove there.
Oh! Oh, I stupid.
I stupid.
I made a big dumb live on television.
We are getting rumble a lot more often lately. Are you still putting Snow Day and Drop Shot?
Yeah.
Oh, that was...
Maybe the Snow Day and Drop Shot people are becoming rarer because we're slightly going up. I don't know. Oh, yeah. Mate, go for it, dude.
I mean, rumble was the most popular of the three to begin with, wasn't it?
Yeah, but once you get to the top
0.5%,
it's hard to find people.
I'm saying, like, it makes sense that we would run into more rumble if that was the one that was previously more popular.
Right.
As people start to lose interest in playing ranked, non-standard silly matches, it's going to be the people that were already into silly matches that are...
Oh!
What I was saying, though, is it also makes sense that we're seeing less people because we're champ in this. And...
Yeah, I think those are both contributing factors.
Oh! Also, I think people are starting to get higher in rank in this, too, because Justin and them were champ 3 yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely nonsense. Oh, you dick. Okay. Good booting me.
Oh, no.
From
down.
No! Another guy hit it! Ah!
Oh, come on. That was nuts. Walker, Texas Ranger.
Punch it! Oh, stop teleporting me! God damn!
Good thing they didn't teleport teammate. That would have been another goal.
Ah! I couldn't see through the smoke.
Oh boy.
Well, it is rumble. 2 goals in 40 seconds is doable. In theory.
Well, I asked it. They just... Oh,
damn, I teleported the goalie, too. Oh, that's...
This is a bad.
Oh, my God.
That ain't gonna happen. This match is lost. Go to forfeit. We got 18 seconds left. That's a time where I'm just like, eh. You know.
We weren't going to win.
Bug's still been randomly flying around my room. I can see him. So you know what? I just want him to be safe. Uh, Did you watch that PSA Sitch video?
Mm-hmm. That was one hell of a slam dunk when he's like, I did email you, as a matter of fact.
And you didn't email me to ask me any questions.
Oh, man.
Oh, God.
Fucking roasted.
That guy's such an idiot.
He does work for Breitbart. Kind of not surprising that he's a bit of a shitty dude. Just the arrogance and the snobbiness with that Twitter rant that he had.
Yeah.
Which, you know, fair enough. Sitch did make a mistake.
Yeah.
But it's kind of, it was kind of a crazy situation that there just happened to be another thing called Insight Labs.
Yeah.
Like that. So, I mean, you know, I'm not gonna pitch a fit. And it wasn't the most important part of the video, like Sitch kept saying.
And the fact that it was internal to Google made it even better.
Yeah, that's like an even stronger argument now. And Sitch did what he could. He apologized. He's like, yeah, I, you know, disregarding everything else, I made a mistake. I apologize for it. Full stop. Like, that's not going to. I'm not going to act like this guy's being a dick. And it is like an important factor to how things play out in this whole grand scheme of things, but yeah, you can just tell that the guy's like, he makes a mistake in the first 5 minutes, so don't even bother watching the rest of it.
Yeah.
Oh, I wasn't sure if that angle would work. If you stole candy from a baby, it would probably start crying, and like people would like look at you and be like, "What the fuck are you doing?" And you'd be like, "Well, it's a baby; it shouldn't really have candy."
Oh, really
ready to great. Eat candy yet?
Also, though, it really depends on how you like steal it, because if it's just like sleeping, it won't give a shit.
Okay, yeah.
But if he's like playing with it and he looks like he's really enjoying the thing that's in his hand, and take it away from him, boy, he's gonna be pissed. Wish I could get there in time, but I don't have a boost. I hear the death of us. There it is. I heard the pew.
And that guy. I think that guy legitimately is reading that chart wrong, because he sent it out again in the tweet. Mm-hmm. Like, here's your evidence! And he's like, you keep going back to that one chart, aren't you? And specifically explained how they were, again, not even saying this is what you should do. And like, what the fuck was that about? We disagree about what the word advocating means?
That's
such bullshit. That is not what is at the heart of this disagreement. You wrote a news article making it look like Google wanted to start censoring people in like the European model. It's just straight wrong. Couldn't be more wrong.
He also said it was opinion piece, even though it wasn't.
Yeah,
he didn't label
not,
it as
not
an opinion
labeled
piece.
Opinion piece. And if you, Sitch shows large portions of that article, and I paused the video to read them, and it's like, no, that did not sound like an opinion piece. You were reporting on that like it was fact.
Yeah.
Although then he wrote like a separate one that was a little bit looser and a little bit more mild in its tone, which is real strange. Because, like, if you actually know that they're not advocating for it, then you're just being blatantly dishonest. A shocker.
Yeah.
But, you know, take down the other one where you're acting like it's legitimate. And then that really weird centrist rant that he went on. Like, Sitch has said before that he leans left. He's not even like a hardcore, like, pounding his fist for being a centrist. Like, what a strange thing. And then acting like a centrist not picking a side somehow is gives them a false sense of entitlement. And
yeah, like centrists have this entitlement or some shit. You're like, but
self-aggrandized view of their political opinions. God damn it.
Oh. That one girl on my Facebook that was complaining about centrists. Like, what the fuck, guys? Like, I don't...
Even if you don't agree with centrists, you have to admire that they aren't stuck in one of the two big sides. That they're like, I'm not going to align myself with one of the two major factions. I have, you know, different views. I think that both sides are somewhat right and somewhat wrong. That at least sounds like a more measured approach than just agreeing with whatever the fuck your party's.
They'll probably also agree with the extremists on both sides.
Oh,
sometimes.
My God.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
If a very conservative person, you're way less likely to have a liberal agree with any of your points of view than you are going to have a centrist. A centrist,
yeah,
potentially
the moderates,
is going to...
The moderates are always a huge factor in elections. Who can sway the moderates? Oh, hello, Angel. I haven't read what you said yet. We need a
Angel.
We need a greeting. Like,
no.
Good Kimochi to you or something. I don't know. Kimochi is good feeling.
Ooh, yeah.
Can't believe that. Kimochi. So like,
Kimochi, good feeling.
Get you a Kimochi.
Get you a Kimochi.
Oh no, not like this. Not like this.
It's in.
I drew other YouTubers as heroes and villains. Any YouTubers that I know? Any of the ones that we talk about? Because that could be fun seeing, like, Chris Reagan be drawn as a hero and villain. Impending Kimochi? Are your good feelings coming?
No. A lot of these are real reaches, some real.
They are. I'm not saying we should go with them. This is brainstorming, my man. You spit.
Well, I'm trading.
You combine.
I just got Magmus boost.
The first guy that said, let's call our nuclear warhead Little Boy, you know, they were probably like, that's not working for us. And he's like, I'm just spitballing.
Yeah,
what about Fatman?
HVAC Markiplier. Philip DeFranco.
Yeah, I used to watch Vsauce. DeFranco a lot. I used to watch Vsauce all the time, but I kind of stopped. Watch a lot of other channels that are like science based and that like explain stuff.
Vsauce, Michael here. I just did a visual thing for the stream. Sorry.
That's okay. When I'm watching the stream tomorrow, I'll see it. Because I always watch the VODs. Every single time. I take notes. That's not true. That's all lies.
I had a thing, and I'm trying to think of it, but I lost it. Just kill me now.
So let's see. What are some other greetings?
Oh yeah, I was thinking of the.
How's it going? How's it, Kimochi? Oh, we were talking about Fat Man and Little Boy, the nukes. I don't know if you had something with that.
Maybe I might have. I did kind of like. You know, a greeting is something that's, you know, it's a first impression. It's like, hey, I'm here. Welcome to the community. The Fat Man, a Little Boy. Man, it really didn't matter what they called those bombs. I don't think the destruction of Japan had much weight on what the bombs were named.
It's just a strange name. Why Little Boy? Little Boy. Well,
I mean, they probably had some concept like, hey, this is a fat man, and then they
changed it. Yeah, like, Fat Man makes sense. It's a big-ass bomb.
But then the second one, it's the shape of it, too, right? The little boy was slender and smaller. Fat Man was fatter.
Yeah, but...
So they probably had Fat Man first.
I mean, slender, that could it could be, like, cigarette. It could be,
But they probably
a lot of things.
They probably came up with Fat Man, and they called it Fat Man, and they had this other bomb that was smaller. They're like, shit, well, what do we call this one? Like, what's smaller than a Fat Man? What's smaller than a Fat Man? Well, Little Boy.
And we're gonna call the bomber Enola Gay.
Yeah.
I actually went to see that. I went to the Museum of
Aviation
and science, like history in Washington. I got to go there. I got to see the Enola Gay. It was really cool. They had a SR71. I was drooling.
Oh, I was really trying to hit that down. I couldn't. Yeah, SR71, sweet. That was like my favorite plane when I was a wee lad, a little boy.
Then we have.
Oh no! What?
They had to make it out of titanium because the heat. Aluminum would just melt at those temperatures.
Oh fuck! Oh boy.
It was like something crazy, like 1,200 some degrees on the leading edge of the wings. When they were getting up to like Mach 2 and 3.
If you
hey Mach,
if it sits on the runway, it leaks fuel.
Yeah,
it has to expand
because it expands when it gets going. And they actually had, when they took off, they had to stop.
Oh my god.
they had to stop taking off with a full fuel tank. Because it was putting a lot of extra wear and tear, and some of like the wheels were failing, so they would take off with like barely enough fuel, and then just like the first thing they would do is go and do like a mid-air refueling. And like I said, they had to make it out of titanium because of how hot it was getting. A little would have fucked up, and there weren't a lot of people that were skilled with working with titanium. Like, the very first step of building it was creating special tools for them to work with the titanium. And then they had to start buying a shitload of it because they wanted to make a whole bunch of SR-71s. And in a real fun twist of irony, they got their titanium from Soviet Russia. they had no idea, because they would buy them through, like, shell companies and stuff. So the Soviet Union had no idea they were selling titanium to the very planes that was going to be flying and doing spy work on them. Yeah, mid-air refueling, the pilots say, was very intense. They literally said it was like the toughest part of flying the SR-71 because in a lot of other planes, the guy was like, he flew like the F-4 Phantom, and he's like, you've got a glass canopy that goes all the way, you know, behind your head. You have amazing vision all around you. But in the SR-71, you've got like a tiny cockpit window because, you know, it's designed for stealth, not for ease of like, you're not dogfighting and shit. And yeah. To make it even worse, the port where they had to match the refueling lever thing was halfway down the length of the plane. So imagine it's like 40 feet behind where you sit. You have to try to match up. Wow, I cannot believe they got that. They had to match up the nozzle from the plane in front of them, like 40 feet behind their head.
It's cool seeing refueling pictures, stuff.
Yeah. They would fly missions that took like 20 some hours. So they would
change it.
They would switch piloting. They would get like 3 or 4 hours of sleep and then be awake for like 8 hours, and then change shifts. They made that shit in the 60s. They started developing that thing.
Yeah.
And literally, as far as we know, nothing else comes close to it in speed, because there's no reason to make a plane any faster nowadays. Like, you know, obviously technology's gotten better, but with satellites, there's really not much of a reason to.
Yeah.
Like, the one advantage it has over satellites is that you can, as soon as you want pictures of a place, you fuel up the jet and you go fly over it and you take your pictures. But satellites, you know, you might have to like adjust an orbit or something if it's not exactly where you want it. But I'm sure at this point they probably have satellites over all the important areas that they would want pictures. It was shot at. Over its lifetime, the SR-71 was shot at 40,000 times by missiles, and not one of them connected, because it was just so damn fast. They actually won't tell us how fast it got up to, but it's rumored to have hit like Mach 5, which is nuts.
Goodness.
Yeah, I love aviation stuff.
I didn't look up facts because I was so young that I like didn't read
it
most just, of the
it
shit.
Looks cool as hell. Even now it looks futuristic. It was made in the 60s and it still looks badass today.
The stealth bomber too, that thing looks crazy.
The B-2? You're talking about the one that's like a big flying wing?
Yeah.
Yeah, that one's really cool. They were trying to make it all the way back into like World War II era. They had designs for a big flying Delta wing like that, but it was like enormous. And they just didn't have. But for one thing, it's like really unstable, and you need a computer to like keep making minor corrections just to keep it in the air. And and obviously computers were real fucking heavy back then. They actually did write, you know, the programs and stuff to like make it work, but it was just heavy and you needed a lot of fuel and just wasn't really worth it at the time. But nowadays, holy shit, they're still using the B-2 bomber now because it's just. It's a stealth bomber that could just like we can just fly a nuke anywhere in the world we want.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, they got rockets that can take them as well, so they don't really need it, but
yeah. It's a Sky Metal Gear.
There you go.
Wow, that guy's name on his Xbox or PlayStation is Thick Pickle Rick.
Everyone closing in. Just everyone came from off frame at the same time. Yeah, I could talk about that kind of stuff for days.
Oh fuck! out of my range. I was gonna plunge it into the net. Oh, he couldn't boot you.
Ooh.
No! Damn. Captain Fire Poo and his emergency punch. Boy, that sounds like a weird avant-garde band.
Yeah. I was thinking Captain Crazy. Crazy anime. Yeah, Thick usually has two C's.
It was probably already taken, which it is...
probably was. You could have put two C's for Pickle and for Rick as well.
Ooh, yeah, you could have.
Double C'd it up all the way around.
All the way down. The more C's, the better.
Sail on the high C's.
Oh, boy.
Ooh, good freeze, good freeze. Aw, damn.
My ball. Ooh. I really fucked this guy. Oh, I hit him. I hit the guy. I think a good freeze. I don't know what that guy is. I turned into Gambit.
You tell Angel about the salad.
I punched it in. It was mine. What?
You tell her about the salad girl. And your success.
Angel, I saw a salad girl and she gave me a... she gave me a sideways smirk and said, I look forward to seeing you again. Or whatever. Forgot the phrase already.
Oh my god. And you talked about your animes.
We talked about animes. We got married. We made baby.
Animes. And animazed.
Yeah. We filed for divorce. It was just, we went through all the motions.
Yeah, it got ugly.
It got uniquely.
Had to split up all the...
all of our assets.
Divorce has got to be...
you hit it in like I did. You did.
Like, on some level, it's good that we've got divorce nowadays. People used to be stuck in bad marriages. You know, at least you stopped having a shit situation, you know? Like, if it wasn't working, you got out of it. But, man, I saw a picture of a couple in court on the ground in a pile of like 200 Beanie Babies on the ground, and they're like separating them out one by one to see who gets what.
Wow.
And it looked soul crushing and depressing.
That's one of those
Anchorman, Will Ferrell. That escalated quickly.
He's gonna drive past me. That's not much I can do.
Could you imagine getting to a point, someone that you loved so much that you thought you were gonna spend the rest of your life with them, getting to the point where you're bickering over who gets which Beanie Baby on the floor in front of the judge?
Yeah.
Ugh.
Imagine that judge too. He's probably just like, fuck it. Just in general, like splitting assets, you gotta sign. What is it, prenup or whatever?
Mm-hmm. But of course, people are like, "Why would you need a prenup if you loved me?" Kind of thing.
But no. the person that hopefully that I get married to will be logical and be like, "Yep, sounds good to me."
Like, no matter how much you love someone, like stuff happens, things change, people change.
What if you get into a car accident and your personality changes? That can happen.
Yeah.
And guess what? I like you for your personality. So if your personality changes, well, and it's shit, and you turn into like an asshole or not a pervert.
That's why, as shitty as it is, the whole like till death do us part thing. I don't even know if anyone actually takes that seriously. They're like,
all formalities, really.
if you murder my whole family, I'm not gonna give a shit about what I said.
Yeah.
When we got married.
Oh.
Also, like, I think people get divorced too easily these days, too. And they get married too fast.
That's what Angel just said. People get married too soon.
Oh, yeah,
I'm going to wait till at least 60, 65. That's what I'm doing. That's, you know, I'm purposefully not married at the moment.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, I've had so many chances, you guys. Oh, man, I've been... Like, just stop with all these proposals, jeez. It's too soon.
I think, you know, since none of my relationships lasted more than a year, as soon as one does, it's time to get married. Like, that's the sign, right? 1 year relationship. I could do like Caitlyn did, fucking get married or get engaged. Oh, fuck, I boosted him. Oh.
63. What a save!
Got engaged within a year of dating this person. Moved to another state with the guy 4 months into the relationship.
Cool. I think I'm gonna have to say that's too soon.
Yeah. Real dumb.
You were saying you think people get divorced too easily. You wanna elaborate on that?
I think it's more of like they go into a marriage like too easily because they know that divorce is an option.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Like, oh yeah, you know, if this doesn't work out, I can just get divorced.
Is that a problem though? Is it a problem if people get married too easily?
I mean, if it's their choice, it's their choice. It doesn't fucking matter, but I think I think people having that mentality going into it's not that healthy, but not if, again, they're the types of people that are negatively affected by it.
Right.
If you have somebody and they don't give a shit if they're going to end up getting divorced later, then who cares?
So, yeah, I didn't mean like it doesn't matter like cosmically or doesn't matter to you. I meant kind of like if you think that because they enter into that marriage too quickly, that it's going to hurt more than if they had been more, if they had taken marriage more seriously.
I think it just kind of like defeats the purpose of getting married in the first place. If you're not gonna like, if you're gonna go into it so easily and you so easily want to break it, then like, what is the
that's
emotional significance?
That's breaking with the cultural norm. But you know, that's, we're kind of shaking things up nowadays. We're kind of breaking up a lot of cultural norms. Like, should we take marriage that seriously?
And that's the thing, is like, because it's a
one way or the other here. I'm just,
you know, for me, I think so because again, it doesn't fucking matter if I sign a paper then to do this thing, right? Like, I'm not gonna go through all these things. And, like, at that point, it's basically just like a regular relationship. Then I might as well not have a ceremony and not go through like the emotional significance to me.
Yeah, I guess it matters. It depends on what. Like Angel's saying, you can have a happy relationship without getting married. What if someone is like okay with the happy relationship part, but just thinks the idea of being married sounds fun, you know, but maybe they don't, maybe they like the idea that divorce is there. I'm not even sure what I'm arguing for right now. I'm just saying, like, we think of marriage needing to be such a serious thing because of its cultural significance. We take it real seriously, but if someone gets married and then is thinking in the back of their head, like, I might get bored of this person and I've got divorce there as an option. You know, maybe you would hurt them. Maybe they'd be like, why the fuck didn't you tell me you're not taking this as seriously as I was?
Yeah, yeah.
You, I mean, there's again, a chance of hurting that person.
Yeah, that's kind of... And of course, again, this is, you know, all to me, in my opinion, right? Because at the end of the day, marriage is fucking... It's for somebody's, like, emotional enjoyment to it. Emotional significance. And potentially tax benefits and shit. But, you know,
It's a weird concept. Why... We decide that, like... You know, the idea of being monogamous, I'm not saying, like, that's weird or anything like that. I get that. But it's strange that we have a ceremony and then involve the government.
Yeah.
And then buy rings for each other, which is all entirely because of a De Beers advertising campaign where they're like, if you really love someone, you would buy them jewelry to commemorate this ceremony. And it just kind of caught on. You know, if you ever, like, wondered why... It became a thing. It's like an advertising campaign to, like, sell more jewelry.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, we decide that we have to have a ring. You gotta have the cake and the flowers, and there's gotta be a witness. And most people, even people that aren't religious, usually do it in a church. And then they have to have a piece of paper you have to sign for the government to prove that you're married.
Yeah. But, like, for me, the main pull is, like, this has emotional significance, right? This is, like, a person wants to devote themselves for their entire lives to me, or, you know, they really want to devote themselves to me. It's not necessarily entire life, you know what I mean?
I guess what I'm saying is that a lot of, there's so much stuff that we talk about where... We kind of deconstruct it and we talk about how people stick to things just out of tradition and or like superstition and how you should take a logical, rational approach. And yet, when it comes to marriage, everybody in here is just a big old sappy romantic. Like, oh, you got to take that seriously. That means something. And I just think it's fun. And it's great. Yeah.
I mean, that's the main appeal of a relationship is emotional significance, and that's what it's going to... give to me is emotional significance, so, like, and logically, if I'm in that relationship for a long time, I might as well get fucking married to him so I can have the government benefits of it. So, but it's also a time sink, right? To get married, I have to go fill out paperwork and all this shit, and then divorce, you have to fill out more paperwork, so I also don't want to do this shit if I'm gonna end up just getting divorced from him anyway, right? Like, oh god, he hit that into me.
Yeah, I'm not arguing that it doesn't have social or emotional significance. I wasn't really arguing for anything in one way or the other. I was just saying, like, we like to break down things for their actual value, and marriage is just, it's such a weird one that, you know, it's. I feel like it's so. It's deeply ingrained. Oh my god!
Fucking shit! Kill me.
It's such a cultural thing. You know, we've been doing it for years. Years. We've been doing it for centuries. And it's just interesting. I'm the same way. You know, I treat it very seriously. And I mean, I'd have to know a person for a very long time before I would trust him like that.
I mean, we like to logically break stuff down and whatnot, but yeah, like,
it's... That one's so purely emotional, it kind of...
Relationships in general are, right? Like... I don't have a relationship because it's logical, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's entirely emotional. And then, like, when it comes to, like Angel's saying, you know, it's hard to come down to the underlying details of emotional things. Like, relationships make me feel good. This marriage thing makes me feel good.
Yeah.
And, like, why? One could say it's because of society and all that shit that brought me up to it, but also...
But it still feels right.
Yeah, it still feels alright, so, like... And it's not necessarily hurting me, right? Like, a significant relationship such as that could end up hurting me in general. So...
It doesn't feel cultural. It feels like you're destined to find the right person. Yeah, like, I'm not like a fan of like rom-coms and stuff, and you know, I'm not usually very sappy, but it feels like there's someone I'm supposed to find and that we're gonna get married and that's gonna like complete my life. But yeah. There's also 7.7 billion people out there. There's probably thousands of people at least that I would fall in love with and be like, wow, I really love this person, and I could see myself spending my whole life with it. It's just a matter of finding one of those people. Because once you've found them and once you've gone through a big portion of your life with them, you're going to be convinced. And even if you found another person, you'd probably already be kind of set.
I also, like, don't believe in soulmates, right? I know
that's what I'm saying, is that, like, we've broken down that before as being, like, illogical and kind of dumb, but there's something about, like, finding someone and being happy and then, like, getting the government involved to prove that you're married.
Yeah.
Being husband and wife kind of thing.
The whole soulmate thing, though, it's a bit more, again, it's like, it's got emotional significance for people, but it's one of those things, like, I just like this person, like,
yeah,
a lot, and there's no way that that's the one person out of 7 billion people that's, like, perfect for me. There's gonna be multiple people out there that's compatible that I could, and the trick is finding them in the hot singles in my area that will...
Yeah. And hopefully they will like you as well.
Yeah. I hit the bottom of that, so it was really just...
Dating sites trying to manipulate white people into being more diverse in their preferences. Oh, so...
Wow.
I shouldn't just go for big boobs, I should also go for big asses as well. Or sometimes a small ass. Is that what you mean?
Big or tiny boobs. Nowhere in between.
But that's not what diverse means. Diverse means black. Oh my god.
I was trying to aim that at the ceiling, please. That's in. Oh boy.
Not if I have something to say about it.
All right, do you have something to say about it?
I do not.
All right.
What do we say to the god of death? Not today. Starting with skin color, but inevitably expanded to body types and whatnot.
Oh, teammate, I didn't know you were gonna land right in front of me. I was trying to take that from you and... Ooh, I would like to diverse my personality liking too, and... Ooh, you know, I'm into nerds most of the time, but fuck it. Yeah, yeah. I'm sort of like outdoorsy, horse-loving, foot fetish chick. Boy.
Well, that YouTube video said I needed to be more diverse.
Ooh, yes, I really like Seinfeld, and,
You got something against Seinfeld?
I don't know, I'm trying to think of something I don't like.
Ugly-ass horse.
Ooh, yeah, thank you, man. Thank you for the ugly-ass horse.
So you're saying if you met a nice horse at a bar one day, and you guys really hit it off, you still wouldn't date her just because she's a horse?
Yeah, probably.
Wow. Honestly, I hope Twitch takes you down for that kind of discrimination and hate.
Yeah. I like to discriminate against just anything that's not human, you know? Ugh.
Wow. Sorry. I had no idea you were such a bigot. This completely changes my perception of you.
Oh, we won that one! Angel. Yeah.
I had a good game. I did a good job in the snow day.
Okay, one more.
Do furries count as humans? Are you talking about things that are furries or the people who are furries?
They must, if you...
To me, hee-haw. I thought it was me, hee-haw. I didn't realize you were saying attracted to me. Hee-haw!
It's haw-haw.
I thought it said me, hee-haw.
See, no. Furries might be like a hybrid.
Do you have a furry suit? If you were gonna get a furry suit, what would it be?
Me?
Yeah. And Angel.
Does it have to cover my whole body? I don't want that at all. I'll get sweaty and disgusting.
None of this was supposed to be pleasant for you.
I don't care about wearing a fursuit that much. Like, if you said you have to wear this fursuit, I wouldn't be thinking I'm gonna look like an idiot.
It's gonna
be thinking
hot.
It's gonna be hot, and I'm gonna sweat like a. I'm not a donkey furry. Excuse me.
I said hee haw.
Oh.
Hee haw. I could have done that.
But if I had to have a suit, what do I think? Man, I don't.
I'd pick something with wings. That's just a fun time to just flap your arms and have wings.
I'd be fluffy. I like fluffy. If I can like touch myself.
Oh yeah, of course. Having a suit be made of like a nice soft material. That makes sense.
You know how much I like touching myself.
I do, Renamon? Actually.
What's Renamon? Like a Kieran outfit would be fine. I'd be fine with a Kieran outfit. Like, you'd be a little less sexy on me, right? But
wait. The Kieran armor or the
Yeah, okay. Kieran armor.
I was like, I thought you meant like a suit that would look like Kieran.
No. Something, you know, you got the fuzzy boots. Mm-hmm. Maybe I'd wear a Speedo instead of short shorts, just to...
Tons of skin. Man, I'm really imagining that now. Is that the little orange dinosaur-looking guy? Is that the mascot for Digimon?
Isn't that Agumon? The orange one's Agumon. Oh, are you talking about the yellow bunny thing?
Oh, I do like bunnies.
Kind of bunny-like.
Oh, if I could be a soft bunny?
That's what I would probably be as a bunny.
But
I'm also my bunny car, so really. That's Agumon. Yellow fox. Fox. Alright, I just remember I had a like old Transformer toy of that. It would like transform into one of its like I think lower forms. One of its lesser forms. Like a furry. I hit it! I really want to punch that in the net. I just... no!
Oh, what a save.
Ooh. Oh, I got another punch. Just get in front of... No! No! Quit teleporting me everywhere, you dicks! Oh my god, yes. Yes! No! Stop! They just won't put it in front of their net. They're just...
Could be fun to be Knocked Owl, though.
I saw an owl yesterday at work.
Oh yeah. I recognize that. That monster. This time I have the picks. One selected. I actually saw it when you put it in. That was a great job on that vector art, man. That looks really good.
Oh, thank you. Fuck! I really got them.
I don't know what that one is, Angel.
Decidueye would be a good call. Decidueye is pretty sweet. It's an owl that, like, he uses his wing for the bow. For, like, bow. And
what
then
is
he,
this?
Like, Decidueye.
This is a Pokemon?
Yeah.
An owl with a bow?
Yeah, he was the grass starter.
Oh, the starter. Okay.
I like Decidueye a lot. I really hope he's in, like, Smash. That'd be cool, but I doubt he's gonna.
Oh, yeah, that's so fucking awesome. I love that.
And, like, if you notice on his...
I gotta save that picture, that's so cool.
If you notice on his wings, he has these, like, yellow triangles. I think each one of those is, like, a new arrow.
Oh, that's so neat.
He pulls them out of his wing.
I love archery and I love owls. Ah, that's so good.
I really wish I could have taken a picture of that owl, Tooken. But for one, yeah, Tooken. He was facing away from me, and two, he was really high up in the tree. But he was making his hoo hoo. I was like, ooh. I like who? Winnie the Who? Horton hears a poo.
Yeah, I would 100% put on a stuffy, furry hot suit to look like that, and have like a neat little plastic arrow.
Yeah, that'd
be... or like a foam arrow.
Yeah, you'd probably have to be foam. No!
Is that like a vine he's using for the string, or is it like?
It's he's wearing like a hood, right? And so it's the pull string for his hood.
Oh, that's super cool.
And like when he pulls the hood, he's like in sniper mode or whatever. Oh god.
Wait, is he flying in grass?
I don't remember. Probably.
Dangly green thing on the other side. I do see that. It looks like a tail.
That's the other drawstring. Good. Grass and dark? Was it? It wasn't grass and dark. Because the fire starter was fire dark. Ghost. Fire. Ghost, yep.
Ghost. Huh.
Yep, okay, I remember now.
Ghost and Dark. No, I'm just kidding.
Ghost and Dark doesn't have a weakness. At least it didn't used to. I think they switched it. I don't remember. Only 5 more tiers to go, Sunbro.
I've got more than enough tiers to go around.
You're a ghost. Okay. I really have to pee, and I gotta switch over.
So. Good noodle.
Good noodle.
Actually,
someday.
I don't think I have to get up early, so I'll stick around and chat.
Word.
In the chat, not and chat. Oh god.
Yeah. Ugh.
Another
ugh.
2 hours okay. with you. Jesus. Fuck. Kill it. Yeah. Kill me.
Terrible. Okay. Pee. Good bye.
Bye. Love you.
Joke's on him. I'm not going pee. Haha. No.